Hi everyone and welcome back to another fun card making video. Today it's the 7th anniversary of Altenew and we gather together to celebrate that with lots and lots of sponsors and tons of prizes. You can see there are over 40 prizes to be won. So make sure to visit my blog. Down below you will find the link if you're watching on YouTube. I'm going to play today and create a lovely card using products from the latest release that include this adorable card on top of a moon. There is also a matching stencil as well as a matching die, which I'm going to use for my card today. A really unique design which features an adorable card that I cannot resist, and it is called Dreamy Cat. Now, the cat on the moon would make a perfect focal point for a standard A2 size card, but it would also work on a slimline card, and the idea is to extend the design somehow by having dangling stars coming down from the moon. I have a long slimline panel here out of a navy blue cardstock, and I cut it out using this set of dies by Altenew. This set not only cuts out the panels, but it also adds a lovely detail along the line that makes it look really finished. And I don't know if the camera catches that detail, but you will see close-up photos at the end. By the way, if you don't have those dies, the panel size is 3.5 by 8.5. Now lately I am kind of obsessed with dark navy blue cardstock and I keep on using it again and again on my backgrounds. One of the things that I like to do is to go all around the edges with a darker shade of blue, which is going to help the cardstock to look even brighter at the center. I am using here my blending brush by Altenew. And the ink is called Arctic Mountain. It is a shade darker and you can see how lovely it shades all around. It doesn't matter if you don't have the best blending, although this brush really makes it easy. I am going to add splashes, I'm going to add my focal points, my sentiments, so nothing is going to look imperfect at the end. Also, when it comes to those blending brushes, I don't have a bunch of them. I have just one for every color family. So I just wipe it off on a clean cloth or on a paper towel and I move on to the next color. It is advised not to mix oxide inks with other inks. However, I don't have any issues with that. I just use this brush for all the blues, no matter which type of ink. All I do is just wipe it nice and clean on a paper towel. Now this panel is supposed to be my sky and I want to have some gold splashes all over the place to look like stars. They are going to be shiny since I am using this metallic palette by Altenew. I didn't show that on camera, however I did test how those splashes are dropping on a scrap piece of paper since I don't want to have any bigger blobs. The color I used for the palette is the gold pearl and I absolutely love it. It is my favorite golden color because it is warm. I'm going to lift the paper and try to catch the light for you. This is going to dry really shiny. And now it's time to do the stamping. I will stamp all the elements that I need to put my card together. So I will go with the cat on the moon. I will also stamp the little fish as well as the speech bubble. You can now use your favorite coloring medium to give some color on the images, whether they are your colored pencils or your alcohol markers, your watercolors, whatever. Today I decided to go with the matching stencils. It provides a quick and easy way to color your images and you can get lovely blending looks without the fuss of alcohol markers. You will see how easy I'm going to use my inks to get that look. Always make sure to use some washi tape or low tack tape like I did here to secure the stencil in place, and then you can go over your area with your blending tool and your ink. For the moon I started with a very bright yellow, which is citrus burst, and since I don't want to have a flat color but rather a blended look, I'm going with a warmer color, which is honey drizzle. I'm going to add that only on one side of the moon. This is really easy to do, especially with those small brushes, and you will end up having a moon that doesn't look flat but rather dimensional. Plus I didn't have to fight with my alcohol markers to get the perfect blending, especially in such a big area. Then I cleaned up the stencil and rearranged that on top of my images. This time, again, I went with low tack tape, and this time I'm going to color the little cat. Of course, you know me, I just have to go with oranges for the cat, always. And the first color is Snapdragon, and then I will add some shadows on top by using Marigold. Now again here I'm using the small blending brushes by Altenew, and this is where the new mini blending brushes come in handy, since I have to add shadows on such a small area. These are really easy to add detail on blending, so you will see that I will be able to add the darker color only at the bottom of the tail, and you will be able to see the result when I lift the stencil. On this type of coloring, you don't really need to know a lot about where the light hits, etc. Just add some shadow here and there. It is going to turn the image looking dimensional, and it's going to look just fine at the end, trust me. Now I am going to work on the cloud. This time I'm going to add just a touch of Silver Lake, which is a very light gray ink at the base. And if you notice, I did use my blue blending brush. I don't have one dedicated for grays. Just make sure that you wipe it off nicely. I don't want to oversaturate that cloud, but still this touch of gray at the bottom is going to give some dimension. The stencil gives you also openings to color the ears and other smaller parts, but I'm not going to bother. I'm just going to use a light pink for the inside of the ears, and I will continue in the same manner. Bright green for the fish. And then finally for the blanket and the pillow, I'm going with a mix of rose quartz, which is this lighter color, and then I will add purple wine for the shadow. I absolutely love how you get the perfect blending in no time, plus you cannot go outside the lines. After I had everything colored, I used the matching dies to cut them out. And I wanted an interactive element on this card with dangling stars coming out from the bottom of the moon. That's why I used a small star die that I had in my stash, and I die cut 6 stars out of gold foiled cardstock. I am going to stick 2 of them back to back, and in between I'm going to sandwich a piece of this thread. This is again an Altenew golden thread. I'm going to place that, and you can see how I sandwich that in between the 2 stars. I'm going to pinch that with a tweezers and let it dry, as I am going to repeat the same process for the rest of the stars. I will end up having 3 of those stars with the thread on top. At the back of my die-cut moon, I'm going to add a piece of double-sided tape. I will peel that off, and this is where I will secure the 3 dangling stars. You can spread them around if you want. I wanted to have all 3 of them close to each other, and I'm also making sure that they are not going to end up at the same height. This is going to add more interest on the card. Now, all 3 of those strings are secured at the back of that double-sided tape. I will use my scissors to cut off the excess thread, and then, you know me, I like to have dimension, so I will add foam tape at the back of this piece, and of course I'm going to make sure that the foam tape is going to go on top of that thread. This is going to secure them even better, and I will know for sure that they are going to stay in place. I'm sticking down the moon towards the top, and you can see how I added something interesting on that long card by having those dangling stars at the bottom of the card. I'm also going to stick down the cloud, and of course he's dreaming of eating a fish. Now at this stage I just have to grab my marker and add that detail at the top of my cat, just to make her look like my ginger. And here is how my panel looks at the moment with all those dangling stars. I absolutely love an interactive element on a card. I think it always brings a smile on a recipient. Now all I have to do is to stick this panel on a pre-folded card that is 3.5 by 8.5, and it is going to fit nicely in the standard business card envelope. Here are some close-up photos on the card that I made for today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. You will find links to everything I used down below in the description area. And don't forget that this is part of a blog hop as we celebrate the 7th anniversary of Altenew with over 40 prizes to be won. Make sure to visit my blog to find all about it.